Good morning, everyone. I'm over here by the piano, in case you're wondering who's talking. Before we begin, I just wanted to say it's great to see so many people here this morning. And we really do appreciate when everyone follows the directions of our ushers and all of our safety protocols. We know that it can be inconvenient at times to sit where you may not want to sit or even have to wear a mask, but these procedures have been carefully and thoughtfully put into place for the safety of everyone, and that includes you. We want you to be safe. Believe me, we don't get droves of people signing up to enforce these protocols because it's not fun, but it is very necessary and very important. So thank you to all who are helping volunteer here at Mass this morning, and thank you to all of you for following these safety guidelines. Thank you so much.
Welcome to St. Anne's. We are pleased that you have chosen to worship with us in person and from afar. In imitation of the Lord Jesus, we value and respect your life with all its personal backgrounds and richness, and its physical and family uniquenesses, and in all its beautiful variety. May you find a home in this faith community. Today we celebrate the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our Mass intention is for William Gregoret. Our celebrant is Father Gabe. There's no speaker, no? Okay. For everyone's safety, remember to follow the directions of your usher. At this time, please double check that your cell phone is turned off. And please stand and safely greet those nearby with your smiley eyes as we begin our celebration.
Good morning, everyone. And let's give a big wave to our people who are in their houses watching us from the homes, and let's just give them a wave, and you know, we're glad you're all here, you know, and that's the rule, is make yourself at home. Let's all gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, that communion and fellowship of Holy Spirit be with all of you today. Thank you. Sisters, brothers, today we are reminded that Jesus calls us to take up our cross and to follow him, to live in a way pleasing to God. He offers us his body and blood as food to strengthen us for a life of love and service. We should not be conformed to this world, but to Jesus, who is our life. For Lord Jesus, you humbled yourself to face death on a cross. Lord, have mercy. Lord, Jesus, you are good and forgiving to all who call on you. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, your love is better than life. Lord, have mercy. So may Almighty God have mercy on us. May this merciful Lord forgive us all our sins so that he can lead us all to everlasting life. Amen. Let's all pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like fire, burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with all of you. This is a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Now Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem. He must suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, "You get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct." Gospel of the Lord. So Adam and Eve was tempted in the garden, and they bit the apple and were kicked out. They thought, you know, earth is God's kingdom. And then Jeremiah, he got the coals, he got the golden tongue, he preached words, and then he got thrown into a sewer, a cistern. And he said, "You duped me, Lord. I let myself be duped. You tempted me and I took it, and here's what I get." Jesus was tempted, and he said, "Get behind me, Satan." And then he was tempted again by Peter. "God forbid you're going to do this. You know, you're not going to be crucified. You're not going to die. No, we will save you." And it was, again, Satan. "Get behind me, Satan. You don't know what you're saying. It is better to die for the world than to live for one's selfish needs. You know, it's better to live life and live it to the fullest, no matter what people say, no matter how you're judged. They will judge you falsely because you have life. And that life does not stop at death. It is eternal. Life and death and life are friends. We live to die and we die to live. Baptism, we're promised eternal life. confirmation, not the evil spirit, but the Holy Spirit dwells within you. We'll be tempted that we're no good. We're tempted that we're useless. We're tempted, oh my goodness, there's no hope from this pandemic. We're all going to die, and that's it. We're tempted to say to people, be damned. And God says, I gave you life. I breathed my spirit within you. Don't let anybody tempt you to think otherwise than that you are pure gift. And that life is not temporary. Your body's temporary. It'll go away. But your life, that spirit of my own flesh and blood, my soul, is breathing within you, and that lasts forever. I want you to be with me, not temporarily. I want you to be with me forever. So let's not be tempted by things that afflict us. Suffering's going to come. Sickness is going to come. St. Teresa of the Little Flower was given a plague of sicknesses and fevers. And she moaned one day, God, if you do this to your friends, no wonder you don't have so many. You know, and she's the little flower. She's the saint. So that's your vocation. That's your call. That's our call, to be a saint, to be God's people, God's beloved ones. Because no matter what we think, no matter what other people think of us, no matter what the world is doing to us these days, you know what? God is well pleased with us. Amen. So let's all rise up. Let's profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. So firm in our commitment to follow the Lord, let us bring our prayers before the God who loves us. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
For church leaders, that their words and actions may inspire each of us to take up our cross and follow Christ, let us pray to the Lord. We pray. For our elected lawmakers, that they may listen to all who cry out for justice, for kindness, and for mercy, and consider their cries when crafting legislation. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray.
Lord,
hear our prayer. That we may value all of God's creation and resolve to care for it and sustain it for future generations. We pray also for the sanctity of God's most precious creation, human life. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For victims of injustice, whether social, economic, or civil, that they may know the Lord's abiding presence in their lives, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here, as we be strengthened in our commitment to deny ourselves, pick up our cross, and lead lives of true discipleship, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the pandemic and for all those who are sick, that they maintain the power of hope in the midst of anguish, pain, and isolation. For those sick in our parish, especially George Bodak, Linda Carson, Christine Cordero, Maymay Dunn, John Kirky, Mary Haeckel, Daniel Kenny, Bernice Konizikia, Linda Meyer, Wesley Moss, Moti Shevet, Laurie Stewart, Amy Valley, and Bernie Virgilio, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember those laid to rest in our columbarium and all those who have died, that they may join with all the prophets and saints in heavenly glory. We pray especially for Rosalind Malloy, widow of Jim Malloy, David Sweet, husband of Frankie, father of Devlin Sweet Tab, Agnes Zelonsky, mother of Terry Hying, and James Zelonsky. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for William Gregoret, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of hope, your Son shows us that the cross is the way to freedom and the fullness of joy. So send us your Spirit that we may embrace the cross with gladness. May the hardships we endure for the sake of the gospel lead all the world to the joy of salvation through Christ our Lord.
Bears are near. Behold the nail.
Sisters, brothers, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Amen. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power, all through Christ our Lord. That Lord be with all of you. Well, let's lift up our hearts. Then shall we give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just. It is our duty, it is our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior, our Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion so as to break those bonds of death and manifest for us all our resurrection. And so, with all the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. This is at the time when he was betrayed, the time when he entered willingly into his passion, that he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, gave that bread to all his disciples, and he said, "Take this, all of you, eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave that chalice to all his disciples. He said, "Take this, all of you drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the world for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we all celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us all worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may all be gathered up into one by the love of the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gregory, John, our Bishop, all the clergy. Oh, remember also our sisters, our brothers, who have fallen asleep in that hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in the abundance of your mercy. Welcome them all into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles, all those saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. Then we can all praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. So at the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all fear, anxiety, distress, because we all await that blessed hope, that coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, keep on reminding us again and again and again with that precious, precious gift. We all have it. Peace. Feel that word in your very soul. Peace. What a gift that is. I leave you peace. My peace I give you. So, Lord, don't look at our sins. Take away all our sins. Look at the faith of your church, your people, your beloved daughters and sons, and grant us the peace and the unity of your home, that kingdom where you live forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Thank you so much. Let's offer one another a sign of God's peace. Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away all the sins of the world. How happy are we to be called to the banquet feast of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. So may the body and blood of Christ bring us everlasting life.
As we begin communion this morning, please remember to follow the usher's instructions as they will help distribute communion by pew sections. Please also remember to wear your mask and to use the hand sanitizing stations before you go forward. And there is no rush, so please take your time and make sure your hands are dry before you approach the priest or Eucharistic minister. Please pray with us the spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Thank you.
Let's all pray. Renewed by this bread from our heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the fruit of charity and love, it may confirm our hearts to stir us to serve you and our neighbor through Christ our Lord. Amen. Kindly be seated again, because Ed's got some special announcements.
Oh, I just have one. It's
just one,
quick,
okay.
Actually, yeah.
But it's special, yeah.
Next Sunday, we're trying something new. The 6 p.m. Mass will be outside on Riley Field. You may have seen some notifications about this, and there'll be more that you can pay attention to in the weekly newsletter and on the website, social media, and in the bulletin. So please look for that. It's going to be on Riley Field. There will be no reservations needed. People will be bringing their own chairs. People, that's you. You'll be bringing your own chairs. And so hopefully if maybe you're not comfortable being inside the church, this will be another opportunity in a more open space to celebrate Mass together. So please, again, check the bulletin and website for more information on that. There is no reservations, and weather permitting, we'll be outside. We'll be under the pavilion, so, you know, whatever.
Oh, yeah.
We're
cool.
Yeah.
We're doing
it. Bring an umbrella. And if it rains strongly, then we'll be moving back into the church. So, all right. Okay. That's it.
That's it?
That's it.
Okay.
That's yeah.
The Lord be with you. Let's bow our heads. Let's pray for God's blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord let his face smile upon you, be gracious toward you. May the Lord look upon you with his ever-loving kindness, give you peace. And may he bless you all the days of your life, so that you all may know that you are God's gift to us, to our world, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. So be at peace, love, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.